Hey everybody, how's it going? Welcome back to Minecraft once again. So I figured I would start off this one. I figured I would grab some more of the bone meal and go back up to the iron farm on my way up there. Let me go ahead and do a stack and a half. I need to head back and finish up my AFK fish farm, but I thought I might also, while I'm out there, go ahead and stop by the iron farm, make sure that's producing as well. If you haven't been joining along with every episode, I'll do a quick recap. We restarted this world after 3 years of abandoning it, and we are working on our farming, our AFK farming. We built the Iron Golem farm, and then we built a AFK fish farm, and now we gotta go finish up on the building aspect of that farm. So, because we're playing on single player and there's really no way to change mob griefing. Actually, here, I'll explain. You can change mob griefing. You can make it so creepers don't blow things up, but that has a huge effect on villagers harvesting the carrots and stuff. The villagers will no longer harvest wheat or carrots or anything like that if mob griefing is turned on. There's like a game rule. Technically, it's a cheat, but if you just change a game rule for the world, then it's just like max entity cramming or something like that. It's just like a game rule. So you could change it so that creepers no longer blow things up, and I think it also affects Endermen picking things up, and it affects gas blowing things up in the Nether, but it also affects villager farming. And that's one thing that I had a hell of a time trying to figure out when I was trying to modify the farm to function like this. Awesome, we got a baby. Oh, shit. I'm going to have to figure out a way to get out of here. Fuck. Wow, that sucks. That really sucks. Because I'm kind of stuck in here. If I try and escape, they're going to try and escape. I don't know how I'm going to do this. I'm going to need to, like, block myself off in a corner. There. And then, so I guess I'm going to have to break that. Block that off so that the little fuckers don't get in there too. Those guys will get anywhere. I always forget that there's like half block zombies. I was like, there was one time that the baby zombies got in and infected my villager area, and I was like, what is going on? I couldn't figure it out, but it was the babies. Oh, we've got a couple of babies now. Excellent. Excellent. This is working out quite well. Because once they have enough babies over here, we're actually going to transport a couple of them to the other side and stuff. So, that's right. I forget that I don't need to plant that. He will plant it. I could break all of these and he would plant it himself. So, I'm just gonna bone meal the shit out of this stuff, and then we'll get back to building on our farm down there. So let's check out the overhead view of our farm. Very nice, very nice. Okay, so that's all the bone meal that I've got. Unfortunately, I have to let those cobblestone blocks disappear. But I do know that this farm is working. That they are breeding. They are breeding quite well. So, let's go finish up the AFK farm. Ooh, do not hit those lily pads. That would be bad. Okay, so it would almost be nice to put the buttons down there. What do you guys think? Button on the bottom. It's actually gonna be... might be a little bit easier to hit. Anyway, I'm only gonna fucking use the right side, but guess I'll switch this one too. Okay, so yeah, let's climb up through here. So this, let me go craft some sandstone stairs. Perfect. So, that is where the roof has to be. So we need to build the wall up one more block. Or do we? I guess we could have... I think on the other one... I forget what I did on the other one. I built this in creative just to make sure I knew what I was doing, but... I didn't exactly know what I was doing then, I guess, huh? Let's just have to see what this looks like. We may have to raise the roof, huh? Get it? Yeah? You know what I mean? Right? Anybody? Anybody there? Well, is this thing on? I'm just kidding. It's a pre-recorded video, obviously, duh. Okay, so check this out. So, at the top, they should come together. If I place them just right, they should come together as like a stovepipe. Right? There we go. It comes together as like, it looks like a half slab, but it's not. It's like four quarter slabs, or four one-eighth slabs, right? It looks like a half slab, but it's really in the middle of four blocks. I think that's actually kind of cool, but... let me double check and make sure that we don't need to change this a little bit. Ooh. Oh, that looks ugly from down here. Ooh. Oh, it looks like it's got like a little mini hat on it. Ugh, never mind. Never mind. Sorry, guys. We gotta redo that. Okay, we gotta run home and get to bed real quick. The sun is already down. I love watching the sunset in Minecraft, but holy crap. Gets a little dangerous when the zombies come out, so... Actually, zombies are okay. I'm cool with them. Skeletons are bad and creepers are the worst, so... Okay, so I did confirm that the way that I built it in my creative design world was that I had made it with sandstone stairs. So, just as I thought, I had made it incorrectly. So, try and figure out a way to build this quickly, but it's a little bit difficult to put down this first layer here. So we'll definitely do this in fast motion so that you guys don't have to watch me build a roof two times. Because it's not that cool of a roof, but it does end up looking kind of cool, I think. Okay, there we go. So, comes to the same peak as it did before, but I think this one's going to look a lot better. Oh yeah, that looks much better. Actually, we've got these scrap blocks on the side here. Let's take care of that before we go looking at everything. Alright, so, nice. We've got a fairly symmetrical looking building. It's got, you know, a couple of different shades, a couple of shades of gray, and a little bit of a tacky sandstone roof, but it looks better than it did before. So, I will call that mission accomplished, so we can spend our time out here fishing for treasures. So, treasures are super important. That's going to help us build some proper gear, some good iron, or some good diamond armor, and some good diamond tools, and we got to find the new mending enchantments, and yeah, that's some cool stuff. So, let's put those on the outside like that, and I guess I'll make sure I get everything else outside lit up. Well enough. Not not going to do anything too fancy. I guess I just want to make sure that nothing's spawning in direct proximity of my new building. Because I don't want to come out someday and have creepers spawning out here. Okay, so yeah, the way it works is everything kind of falls down here into these chests down here. Let's see, I do have enough hoppers to make a couple more. Let's do at least one more set right here. And we'll make this into stone. So stone there. Actually stone there. And that's a hopper. So I'll put that in the corner there. And I'm going to make one more chest. I guess I need a double chest because I stole a chest, so I technically need three right there. So, one, two, hopper. Let's jump up here to place hopper. Down here, chest. I guess I need to encase this in some stone, actually. Let me get my axe and shovel. I just want to make sure that I'm only seeing this. Okay, maybe under there I might at some point see it. So that's the only spot. Other than that, the rest of it shouldn't bother me too much. I'm really only using these chests here. Because everything just flows on down into those, so. I think sometimes I put a block there. Doesn't need to. And I usually put blocks there. Other than that, that's pretty much it. It's a real simple farm. It's a real simple farm. Let's duplicate what's on the outside, I guess. Sure things are well lit up back here. Alright, that's pretty much it. Let's check where the sun is at. Sun is almost down. So yeah, I guess. I think that pretty much do it for this episode. I don't know how much time-lapse we did, but I think this will make for a reasonable episode. We got our fish farm done. We got our iron farm working. I guess I will come back for the next episode and get some of those villagers transported, I guess. I don't know. I will probably do, come back and, I don't know. I guess I'll figure out what I'm going to do with the AFK fish farm. It's like how much to record of that and how much to show you guys. I think I'm just going to have to... just gonna have to go ahead and sit over there for a while on the AFK, and I guess I want to get this iron farm figured out before I do too much AFK on the fishing. But yeah, that's the only situation there. But yeah, I'm pretty sure that's gonna be our next task, is getting a few more villagers onto the other side so that we can complete our iron farm for reals this time. So, well, anyways, thank you guys very much for watching. I appreciate you hanging out playing Minecraft with me, and thanks guys. See you next time. Okay, I figured I'd spend another day building. I've got a couple more projects to do, just a couple little tiny little upgrades and stuff. Let me put a few things back in the chest. I've just kind of been using that as a junk chest. I probably need to just make another junk chest right above it. So let's toss a couple of building blocks up in there. And let's go grab some more bone meal. Oops, wrong chest. Let's grab this bone meal. And let's grab some more dirt. I want to get everything up in that iron farm prepared for the next steps. So, let's get this ready. Okay, so I'm going to fill this bucket on the way up there. But let's run on out to the golem farm. It's always hairy jumping up off that ladder. I never know exactly what I'm doing. Okay, so it's been a couple days since we've been up here. They are definitely breeding. That's good. You've got a white apron, black apron. Black apron. Dang it. Dang it. We need at least one more farmer villager coming out of this. So before we can move them on over there, we're going to need another farmer. So that's all the food I brought. Dang, I should have brought better food. Huh. Okay, so we gotta get this prepared real quick. Nothing too special. There. Okay. Okay, so I'm just gonna run a line across here and get this kind of semi-prepared for next time. Or not next time, but whenever we get ready to move the villagers. So we're just gonna need to move them just from one side to the other. It's not going to be quite as elaborate as moving them all the way from the other side of town. So, shouldn't be too bad, but gotta get her prepared. Okay, so what's going to happen is they're going to go from that spot. They're going to come up here, and they're going to get pushed on over here. So, I guess I'm just going to light this place up a little bit. That's probably about good. We just wanted to get a little bit prepared. I don't really need to go too overboard. I just need to make sure that this is ready before I actually go AFK over there at the fish farm. So we also need to figure out what's going to happen to the iron golems once they fall through. So let's not kill ourselves right here. We need to make sure that this is enclosed, because otherwise I'm going to start spilling iron golems out all over the place. So, I should have brought glass. Okay, we got plenty of glass here. So, let's use that. Dang, I wish I had a lava bucket somewhere. I wonder if I do. I wonder if I do. I may have to go downstairs and get one. But I guess let's get this thing built for now. Ooh, let's grab some signs, too. Did I have any signs left over? I did, yes. Let's grab those. What else do we need? What else do we need? What else do we need? That'll do for now. Okay, so they're all going to fall down right about here. So we need to encase this area in glass. Also gonna need to put a hopper. God, I hope hoppers are working proper. I don't know what the story is with that. If any of you guys have ever encountered that kind of stuff, let me know. I'm still confused about that. I guess for now we can do let's do this. So there and there. And then we can do the front for two, because the iron golems are actually three tall, so I can actually make it so I can walk into it. Although that is actually quite dangerous, but for now, that's what we'll do. Okay, so now I need to connect all of that as one straight tunnel. Oops. Derp. Okay, so we need to connect all of this. So let's start from the back. And then I'll just jump off into the water. And keep doing that a couple more times. Thank you. Okay, so I definitely pushed the limits. The sun is going down. We just about got her done, and yeah, almost got enough. Almost didn't bring enough glass, but okay, so that is connected. We need to go up one, and yeah, everything's there. Cool, so now that's good, and we can just break this and fall into the water. Okay, so everything's connected, and let's go back to bed. Thank you guys very much for watching. Appreciate you guys hanging out. Hope you guys like a nice long episode. And yeah, thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoy. See you guys. Oh, shit. Run away from the skeletons. Run away. Let's just go sleep in a bed. All right, I'll see you guys next time. We'll deal with him in the morning.